Hi everyone, Seb from Shapr3D here. Our team has been working hard on a new batch of improvements to the Shapr3D app, and I wanted to take a couple of minutes today to walk through them with you. You can now use dark mode on Windows too. Whether it helps reduce strain on your eyes, or you just think it looks gorgeous, it's now available for you to try out. Simply navigate to the settings area and enable it. We've updated lighting within the model space for dramatically better highlights and shadows. We think this will help you better understand the geometry you're creating in Shapr3D, and I also think it looks simply gorgeous, especially in dark mode. Here's a quick shot of how things looked before the change for you to be able to compare. We've implemented the first batch of keyboard shortcuts to help you make your design process as productive as possible. You can make sure they're enabled by navigating to the settings area and switching the default single key action to hotkeys. You can also see a list of the available keyboard shortcuts within the menu area here. You can still access command search by clicking X on your keyboard. For a full list of the keyboard shortcuts, you can find the link within the description to our support site. We have a new measurements panel to make it easy for you to extract different dimensions for the things you're modeling right in context. This set of features has been in the product for a couple of weeks now, but so many of you have been requesting this that I just had to call it out. You can now create linear and circular patterns right within Shapr3D. You can define patterns either using the space between elements or the total distance you would like the pattern to cover, and you can also set the number of elements within the pattern. Patterns automatically get constrained together, so you can easily get back to them and have changes you apply to one element propagate out to other elements within the pattern. And of course, you can create circular patterns just as easily as linear patterns. We've updated the scale tool for both sketching and solid modeling. You can now use non-linear scale to scale along one or more than one dimension. We've also been working on improving the spline tool recently, and we've just released the first batch of those improvements. We've been focusing on control point splines and made the user experience much easier to manipulate. We've also been working on improving visualization. There are now 88 materials to choose from and 9 environments with customizable lighting. Here you can see visualization in action with a couple of the new fabric textures on these chairs. We've also added depth of field to help make your designs look even more realistic in visualization. To use it, simply tap or click on the area you want to focus on and we'll take care of the rest. As usual, we can't wait to see the amazing things you design in Shapr3D. Our team here is already busy preparing the next batch of improvements to the application. We're currently drawing up improvements to one particular feature, which I think many of you will be excited about. If you think you know which one that is, let us know in the comments. Thanks so much for joining us. See you next time.